Hi students, welcome to MPED channel. My name is Hitesh Narashe, I am from Honavar. I will teach you mathematics and physics part of science. Today, I am going to explain about a topic from the 10th standard. Before starting my topic, I will tell you some basics about mathematics. So I hope you know mathematics from 9 years, 10 years, 8 years or whatever it may be. Thought you know about mathematics. So I have a question for you. What is mathematics? So just pause the video here and don't refer any social media, don't refer any other books. Try to think out your knowledge. Just pause the video here and try out your knowledge. Yes, I hope you did that. So, mathematics is a language of numbers. There are many vast definitions are there about mathematics. So, neglecting those definitions, just consider mathematics is a language of numbers. So, I hope you know many languages like English, Kannada, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu or Urdu. So whatever it may be, all these languages have their own literatures. Also, the mathematics is also a language. That means here mathematics is also have a literature. That literature is nothing but numbers. So that means no numbers, there is no mathematics. No mathematics is meant for there is any no numbers. Okay. So then what is meant by numbers? Numbers is the basic property of mathematics. I have told that no numbers means no mathematics. That's why requires mathematics is a language of numbers. So there are two ways of representing or identifying number. In a value concept, there are two ways. So number can be classified into two ways of representing, that is, one is the base value, another one is the place value. As the name only indicates, face value. So look at my face. So it looks like Hitesh Narashe. So half of one hour knows my name, my face belongs to the Hitesh Narashe. So what is the face value here? I am looking handsome, I am looking gorgeous, I am smart. So this is my face value. Then what is the place value here? So what is the place here? So I am a teacher. So the place of teacher is easily respected from the society. What is my place value? So the place value of a teacher is respect. So let us consider a number. Yes. What is this? Whether it looks like any Shah Rukh Khan, Salman Khan or Amir Khan? No, it's just the value 2. So the face only indicates the value 2. I have 2 eyes, I have 2 ears, I have 2 chalk pieces. So the face value of 2 is always 2. Likewise, the face value of 5 is also 5. The face value of 6 is also 6. So likewise. So let us consider another number, 2222. So much bigger number than 2. How can I identify? From the base value, because 2 is only 2 are there. Here there are 4 2s are there. So from the base, I identify 2222 is much better than 2. So there are 4 2s are there. Let us consider one value. What is the base looks like? 2. What is the base value? Again 2. What is the place here? So it's in the digit place. So the place value of this place is only 2. So let us consider this place. So this 2 is in the 10th place. That means the place value of this is 12. 20. So let us consider this place. This place is in the 100th place. So that is, so the place value of this 2 is 200. So again, what is the place value of this? So because this 2 is in the 1000th place, that means the place value of this 2 is 2000. Likewise, from the value concerned, we are representing numbers in two ways. One is a place value, another one is a place value. I hope you understand about mathematics and what is numbers. Today, I am going to explain about a topic from the 10th standard, that is real numbers. Hope you understand about numbers. So there are two ways of representing numbers. One is the face value, another one is the place value. Neglecting place value, so considering only the face value, there are so many ways of representing the numbers. So consider 2. So I just inserting minus sign here, the face value changes. So again, I will put a denominator as 1, the place, face also changes. Just I put a root sign here, it also changes the face value. So considering these face values, the numbers are divided into many number sets. So the union of all these numbers are included in the real number set. So real numbers are the union of all the numbers. Also, real numbers are the union of rational number sets and irrational number sets. That means real numbers are categorized into two types. That is, one is the rational numbers, another one is the irrational numbers. Again, rational numbers are divided into two types. So that is, one is a fraction, another one is a integer. Again, integers are divided into two types. One is a negative integer, and another one is a whole numbers. Then again, whole numbers are again divided into only one type, that is natural numbers. All these number sets are represented by some symbols. Real numbers are represented as R, rational numbers as Q, irrational numbers as P, integers as Z, whole numbers as W, and natural numbers as M. So let us discuss about one by one. So we already know that the real numbers are union of these rational number sets and irrational numbers. So simply, the rational numbers are the numbers in the form of P by Q. P and Q are integers. Not equal to 0. That is, the denominator for term R is not equal to 0. So irrational numbers are the non-terminating and non-recurring decimals are included in the irrational number set. For example, root 2, root 3 or 5. So these numbers are included in the irrational number set. So rational numbers, you know that. So rational numbers are again divided into fractions and integers. Fractions is nothing but the numbers in the form of P by Q. P and Q are integers, Q is not equal to 0. So integers are those numbers where the fraction is converted into integers when the denominator part when is equal to 1, so the fractions are converted into integer number sets. So integers are again divided into two types, negative integers and whole numbers. Negative integers, for example, -2, -3, -1 and so on, the numbers prefixed by a negative sign. So whole numbers are the positive integers and 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. And the natural number set is the only counting numbers. We are start our count from the 1, 2, 3 and so on. So let us we discuss about real numbers. So I hope you understand all the number sets about real numbers. Dear students, today we discuss about another topic from 10th standard, that is Euclid's division lemma. Euclid's division lemma. There are three terms here: Euclid, division, and lemma. So you don't know about Euclid and lemma, but you know about division. So one of the major mathematical operations is division. Likewise, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Division is also one of the major mathematical operations. So Euclid, a famous known mathematician, so he is also called as father of geometry. So lemma is nothing but a proven statement used to prove another statement. That is, lemma is a statement we have to prove previously. So that previously proven statement is used to prove another statement. So hope you know about Euclid's division lemma. So there are three terms here. From these terms, we have to understand Euclid's division lemma. So Euclid's division lemma states that if A and B are two positive integers, if A and B are two positive integers, I hope you know about integers, negative integers and positive integers. So A and B are two positive integers, then there exists two unique integers Q and R. Then there exist two unique integers Q and R. They must satisfy the condition. They must satisfy the condition A is equal to BQ plus R. The Euclid's division lemma is a statement. The statement states that if A and B are two positive integers, then there exist two unique integers Q and R. They must satisfy the condition A is equal to BQ plus R. We know that Euclid's division lemma. So this is about division. When we divide A from B, so we have to make a division here. So we have to divide A from B. So we get the quotient here and the remainder. So this is the dividend, this is the divisor, this is the quotient, and this is the remainder. So after this division, we have to express this division as a A is equal to BQ plus R. That is true for all the positive integers. So this is not a new term. You have already learned in a 9th class. In a remainder theorem, that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So we have a dividend here A, divisor is B, quotient is Q, and remainder is R. So let us, we consider any two positive integers, we have to divide. After dividing, so it can be expressed in the form of A is equal to BQ plus R. So let us take one example. A is equal to BQ plus R. Another one term there, R is always greater than or equal to 0 and less than B. So R is less than, greater than or equal to 0 or less than B. So let us consider one example. 45 is divided by 6. So after dividing, so we get the quotient as 7. 6 into 7 is 42. So we get the remainder as 3. So it can be written in the form of 45 is equal to 6 into 7 plus 3. So here there are two terms, two positive integers. One is a 45, another is a 6. Then there exist two unique integers, 7 and 3. They must satisfy the condition 45 is equal to 6 into 7 plus 3. So we can solve it. 42 plus 3 is equal to 45. This is true for all the positive integers. So we have known that lemma is nothing but a proven statement used to prove another statement. Likewise, there is some uses. So let us know about what are the uses of Euclid's division lemma. So uses. First one is to find the division. To find the division of two numbers. Secondly, to find the HCF of two numbers. So there are two uses of Euclid's division lemma. So one is to find the division and to find the HCF of two numbers. So we have already learnt about the division. The Euclid's division lemma is used to find the division. So let us discuss about to find the HCF of two numbers in the next class. So take some homework. So you have to express these numbers in the form of Euclid's division lemma. Express in the form of Euclid's division lemma. First one, 55 divided by 8. Second one, 45 divided by 9. And third one, 37 by 5. So make these calculations and express these divisions into Euclid's division lemma. So dear students, in this class we shall discuss about mathematics, numbers, real numbers and Euclid's division lemma and its uses to find the division. So thank you very much.